Hello students, today's lesson is Scope and Fields of Gerontology. This lesson is about the scope and fields of gerontology. The major purpose of this text is to introduce various fields of gerontology like biological gerontology, medical gerontology, neurogerontology, social gerontology, cultural gerontology, psychological gerontology, industrial gerontology, financial gerontology, geographical gerontology, and physiological gerontology. It also explains the scope of gerontology for better understanding of the gerontological practice. On the completion of this lesson, you should be able to describe the scope of gerontology, and you can understand the different fields of gerontology, and also to know biological, psycho, and social domains for the gerontology. Gerontology is the branch of study which is concerned with the aged and aging. In other words, it is an approach towards the aged people. Gerontology is the scientific study of the phenomenon of aging. By aging is mean the progressive changes that take place in a cell and tissues and organ system, a total organism or a group of organisms, which the passage of a time. Aging is the part of developmental sequence of the entire lifespan. However, gerontology is concerned primarily with the changes that occur between the attainment of maturity and the death, and with the factors that influence these changes. The field of gerontology is diverse and multidisciplinary, as gerontologists work in various fields to improve, promote, and support elderly individuals. Gerontologists typically work directly with the older or elderly adults, often as advocates or caregivers. The issues of the elderly can be applied to so many areas of academics and the sciences. It is a broad and diverse field of study. The work of a gerontologist is so vital to understand the needs of the elderly individuals. Without the compassion, research, and responsibilities of gerontologists, many elder people would not have the proper care or quality of life that they may require. In this context, the fields of gerontological practice may help and guide the professionals to provide better services to the older people. Let us know about the various fields of gerontology and the scope of gerontology. So, the scope of gerontology is very broad and encompasses the psychological, socio-economic, and physiological aspects of the old age. The multidisciplinary focus of gerontology means that there is a number of subfields as well as associated fields that all work with old age. The person in the age group of 60 and above, even though regarded as senior citizens, are deprived of honor which they should get and the status they are required. There are different problems of aged people, different problems of male and female aged, rural and urban residents, and belong to the different communities. When we pursue the history, it reveals that earlier the lifespan was very short, but now due to the technological inventions, improved lifestyle, better eating facilities, and modern medical facilities, treatments led to extension of lifespan the human being. The scope of gerontology is going to expanding day by day due to the extensive issues of aging, especially older people. Recently, gerontology and geriatrics, which subclassification of different subsidiary branches, have been recognized. These two branches deal with two different aspects in the human life, and both are equally important. Gerontology is distinguished from geriatrics, which is the branch of medicine that specializes in the treatment of existing disease in older adults. The scope of gerontology includes studying physical, mental, and social changes in the people as they age, and investigating the biological aging process itself. It's called as biogerontology, and investigating the social and psychosocial impacts of aging, social gerontology, and investigating the psychological effects on aging, psychogerontology, investigating the interface of biological aging with aging associated diseases, geroscience, investigating the effects of an aging population on society. the multidisciplinary nature of gerontology means that there are a number of subfields as well as associated fields such as psychology, anthropology and sociology that overlap with gerontology. The subfields are biological gerontology, medical gerontology, neurogerontology, social gerontology, cultural gerontology, geographical gerontology, industrial gerontology, psychological gerontology, jurisprudential gerontology, financial gerontology and physiological gerontology. Biological gerontology. Let me talk about biological gerontology. It is the subfield of gerontology concerned with the biological aging process, its evolutionary origins and potential means to intervene in the process. It involves interdisciplinary research on biological causes, effects and the mechanisms of older adults. Biomedical gerontology also involves known as the experimental gerontology, and life extension is a sub-discipline of biological gerontology that endeavors to slow, prevents and even reserves aging in both human and animals. By preventing senescent changes in animals, these therapies would prevent the onset of age-related disease and frailty, extending both average and maximum lifespan. In contrast with biological gerontology, geriatric studies the treatment of disease in aging people. Both fields are considered by many scientists to be the most important medical frontier in aging research. It is one of the important subfield of gerontology. Aging is a continuous process that constitutes a cycle studied with events that affects all systems in the body. The interrelationship between the aging process and the body is complex, involving a variety of factors, and it could affect the aging. To understand of the medical gerontology, it is important to have some knowledge on human body, including a structural biochemistry, connective tissue cells, molecular genetics, and the extracellular matrix. Medical gerontology deals with aging impact on the all systems in the body. It is a specialty that focuses on healthcare of elderly people. However, it is called as geriatric medicine. It aims to promote health by preventing and treating diseases and disabilities in older adults. There is no set age at which patients may be under the care of geriatrician or a geriatric physician, a physician who specializes in the care of elderly people. Neurogerontology is a hybrid of the discipline of neuroscience and gerontology, two rapidly growing diverse fields with the multifaceted basic scientific and clinical dimensions. It tells the story of how the aging brain affects all aspects of cognition and physical performance. A nervous system consists of numerous cells, the most important of which are neurons. Collectively, the neurons that make up our own nervous system have features that are difficult for the human brain itself to understand. Neurogerontology deals with the nervous system and aging aspects of physical performance of brain. It comprehensively links the principles and substance of neuroscience with the gerontology and psychology. Written largely from a behavioral neuroscience perspective, neurogerontology explores the functional relationships between the central nervous system and psychological phenomena of aging, including perception, arousal, learning, cognition, and motor behavior. It is also studies about healthy aging, dementia, and other pathological risk conditions of human brains. Social gerontology is a new field of research and has come to be a broad and many-faceted field concerned with the both individual and social aspects of aging. As the field has developed, four principal phases have conveyed. One is the biological changes, changes in psychological capacities and performance, change in position of the individual in society, and the way the aging individual organizes the feelings, self-concepts, and behavior in response to the pressures of society and to internal changes. Social gerontology is a multidisciplinary subfield that specializes in studying or working with the older adults. It is concerned with the study of social aspects of old age. Traditionally, social gerontology has concentrated on the study of social, economic, and demographic characteristics of older people and an aging population. However, in recent years, the scope has expanded to include health, technology, and overall lifestyle. Social gerontology covers individual experiences of aging, age identities, social networks and supports, life events, coping and resilience, etc. The social institutions that provide health and social care services to the older people, how old is socially constructed, and age-related inequalities that flow from this. The factors that drive social and health inequalities in old age, such as class, gender, ethnicity or race, and the broad social impacts of our aging populations. But central to these studies has been a concern to understand the factors that promote or undermine the well-being or quality of life of older people. Social gerontologists may have degrees of training in social work, nursing, psychology, sociology, demography, or other social science disciplines. Social gerontologists are responsible for educating, researching, and advancing the broader causes of older people, because issues of lifespan and life extension need number of quantify them. There is an overlap with demography. Those who study the demography of the human lifespan differ from those who study the social demographics of aging. And next one, cultural gerontology. Culture is used in varying and sometimes contradictory. Culture is better understood here as a set of influences containing contradictory definitions and theoretical approaches. Cultural gerontology specifically emerged out of a desire to escape the dominant paradigm that presented later years within a social welfare and public policy framework that emphasized frailty and burden. Cultural gerontology, indeed, seeks to identify and understand the specificities of cultural contexts, whether revealed in literature, historical analysis, art, or ethnography. Cultural gerontology reveals and divides culturally determined perceptions, attitudes, and effects of human aging that are not accentuated within other disciplinary approaches. The term culture does not require ignoring economic, social, political, and other impacts on aging, but the study of culture with its multiplicity of forms enhances our interrogation of both individual and social choices and constraints connected with the aging. It also explores, for example, the cultural means that can help people and groups to respond to the pressures and opportunities they encounter as they age. It analyzes expectations and practices that can help aging adults to exercise power and resist it, to confront obstacles or sometimes to create them, and to make their lives meaningful both to themselves and to the others. The arts, humanities, and social sciences thus have a fundamental role to play in the study of human aging and form an invaluable complement to other areas of gerontological research. Aging is a key narrative of the 21st century. Around the world, individuals, households, communities, organizations, business, industries, governments, and civil societies are facing the opportunities and challenges of unprecedented number of older people. Understanding where aging occurs, how it is experienced by different people in different places, and what ways it is transforming our societies, economies, and environments at all levels. In other words, the geography of aging has become crucial for the development of informed research, policy, and programs. Whilst geographical questions are not new to gerontology, the implications of population aging for families, healthcare systems, and public finance, etc., in an era of global economic, environmental, and technological change have made them more important than ever. So geographical gerontology is a burgeoning body of interdisciplinary scholarship encompassing the application of geographical perspectives, concepts, and approaches to the study of aging, old age, and older population. Geographical gerontology as a contemporary field of study, and it was emerged at the confluence of a long-standing disciplinary tradition within geographies of aging, the result of growing body of interdisciplinary scholarship. Many of the geographers, gerontologists, and allied scholars from across the health and social sciences are studying about aging, old age, and older populations. Underlying the evolution of the field, both within the geography and gerontology, is a long-standing and increasingly nuanced appreciation for the reflexive, transactional, and mutually constitutive relationships between the older people and the spaces and places in which through age and aging occurs. Indeed, the importance of geographical constructs, that is place, space, scale, landscape, territory, and so on, is playing a vital role in the process of aging. Geographies of aging. Gerontology and geography have a close relationship within the distinct boundaries, that is identity and representation, emotion and embodiment, care and caring, health and well-being, aging in a place and emplacement, living arrangements and environment, urban planning and housing, healthcare and services, movement and migration, including demographic aging. So geographies of aging is projected to affect all countries across the world in coming decades. Moreover, geographies of aging is spatially persistent, affecting every man, woman and child. We need to practice the geographical gerontology within the broad boundaries of human and social gerontology. This has considerable implications at policy and practice level response in order to get the economic, social and healthcare outcomes in the field of aging. Environmental gerontology. Environmental gerontology or ecology of aging is typically identified with the description, explanation and modification of the relationship between the elderly person and his or her physical environment. It is a specialization within gerontology that seeks to develop an understanding, means of analysis, opportunities to modify and interventions that optimize the relationship between the aging person and their physical and social environment. Utilizing interdisciplinary perspectives and approaches to attain these goals, environmental gerontology seeks to understand the socio-spatial implications of aging and its complex relationship with the environment. From analysis at different scales, micro scales, home and family, and macro scales, neighborhood, city, or region, to enable social and environmental planning and policies that enable better aging. Among the main contributions of the discipline are the contributions to aging in place, wherever that place may be, and that older people prefer to age in their immediate environment, where aspects such as spatial experience and place attachment are important for the understanding the process. And psychological gerontology. The scientific history of the psychology of aging is quite brief. From pioneer work by G.S. Hall in 1922, Charlotte Mahler 1933, Carl G. Jung in 1933, and Walter Miles in 1933, theoretically developments in psychogerontology started basically after World War II. The first, the psychology of aged focuses on older people and later life, grounded in a stages of life perspective. Most of the studies on the aged demonstrate a thematic descriptive approach and little coherence, that is example studies of Alzheimer's disease, life stratification, widowhood, retirement, cognition, death and dying. The second approach in psychological gerontology falls within the psychology of age, which studies age differences in behavior by comparing groups of different ages. Old age is a life stage characterized by long past and short futures. It is a time of loss, the loss of spouse, friends, jobs, standard of living and health. Old age is that life cycle stage when individuals often must face life's most stressful experience. Older adults experiencing psychological problems encounter the stigma of mental illness along with their relatives, spouses or partners and caregivers who experience courtesy stigma. The psychological gerontology deals with the above problems of older adults. Clinical psychologists specializing in psychological gerontology work with individuals, older adults, family members of the older adults, including spouses or partners, siblings and adult children and caregivers. When treating these psychological problems experienced by older adults and dealing with the issues of caregiving to older adults, experiencing mental illness, dementia, and psychological reactions to co-occurring medical illness. These mental disorders contribute to the loss of interest in socializing and finding meaningful hobbies or voluntary activities. The field of psychological gerontology exists to understand and help to deal with these changes by studying both the physical and mental aspects of aging. Industrial gerontology. Industrial gerontology is a study of aging and work, focusing on the adaptation of middle-aged and older workers to employment and their transition to the retirement. Major areas include social policy and law, stereotypes of the older workers, selection, job performance and appraisal, training and retraining, career progressions and development, motivational factors and organizational design, re-entry workers, alternative work, patrons, safety, plant closings and layoff and retirement decisions. Industrial gerontology was beginning in Great Britain to address the issues in aging and work. Research was motivated by concern regarding the effects of technological change and automation on the older workers. The negative stereotype of the older workers has been a major concern for several decades. The social impact of The stereotype is substantial when maintained by an employer and creates even greater problems when held by older persons themselves. In industrial settings, employers encourage older workers to take early retirement buyouts, and they are reluctant to hire or offer training to persons older than age 40 or to train or retrain those already employed. Many middle-aged and older workers have been affected by layoffs, downsizings, and plant closings, etc. A common theme in gerontology for a good many decades have been the training and retraining of older adults workers. The growing awareness that older adults can be trained and retrained in both laboratory and industrial setting has led to the development of training principles and methods that recognize the unique attributes of the older adult workers. Aging is a physiological change that takes place in the human body, leading to senescence, the decline of biological functions and of the ability to adapt to metabolic stress. Gerontology is a study of social, cognitive, psychological, and biological aspects of aging. Physiological changes occur with the aging in all organ systems. The impact that aging has on organism is a complex interaction between the process of aging at a cellular, organ, and integrated systems level, and the effects of environmental factors such as nutrition, infection, and trauma. Recovery from an insult that triggers a pathological response is never complete. The incremental fall in possible performance is a part of the progressive diversity in physiology. That is the true hallmark of aging. Physiological gerontology deals with the physiological changes and processes associated with the aging. Jurisprudential gerontology. Jurisprudential gerontology is a specialization within the gerontology that looks into the laws and legal structures interact with the aging experience. The field started from legal scholars in the field of elder law, which found that looking into legal issues of older persons without a broader interdisciplinary perspective does not provide the ideal legal outcome. Using theories such as therapeutic jurisprudence, it is a study of effects of law and the legal system on the behavior, emotions, and mental health of the older people. And the jurisprudential scholars critically examined existing legal institutions, that is adult guardianship, end of life care, or nursing homes, regulations, etc., and showed how law should look more closely to the social and psychological aspects of its real life operation. Other streams within the jurisprudential gerontology also encouraged physicians and lawyers to try to improve their cooperation and better understand how laws and regulatory institutions affect health and well-being of older persons. Financial gerontology. Financial gerontology is a multidisciplinary field of study encompassing both academic and professional education that integrates research on aging and human development with the concerns of finance and business. Following from its roots in social gerontology, financial gerontology is not simply the study of old people, but emphasizes the multiple process of aging. In particular, research and teaching in financial gerontology draws upon four kinds of aging, that is called as four lenses, through which aging and finance can be viewed. One is the population aging, number two is individual aging, number three, family aging, and generational aging. Through the lens of individual aging, demography also notes changes in the length of the time of number of years lived in older age, typically measured by increases in life expectancy. From in its founding years in the beginning of the 21st century, one primary interest of financial gerontology has been on baby boomers and their relationship with their parents. The impact of these two kinds of aging on finance are reasonably apparent. The large and increasing number of older persons in the society, no matter how old age is defined, longer each of these persons lives, that is called as individual aging, the greater impact on a society's pattern of retirement, public and private pension systems, health and healthcare, and the personal and social financing of the healthcare. The focus of boomers illustrates also the other two lenses or kinds of aging. How boomers deals with the social, emotional, and financial aspects of their parents. Aging is a central aspect of family aging, and how boomers may differ from their parents born and raised 20 to 40 years earlier and differ from their generation called X and the millennial children and the grandchildren. A substantial aspect of the generational aging the sudden increase absolute and relative number of older people means that more and more people will be entering the age when the risk of developing certain syndromes of frustration and chronic disease would be higher. In these circumstances, population aging will be lead to serious challenges for national peace and public health. Growing population of elderly or aged will put financial burden on the pension schemes, health insurance, travel benefits or exemptions, etc. It also leads to the mental health problems. The growing social, economic and public health consequences thereof of aged people are required to be taken very seriously. In this circumstance, they require some mechanisms to cope up with this situation. From this viewpoint also, gerontology plays an important role. And Jonah Meller and John Ivory in 2002 explained the bio, psycho and social domains of gerontology in their study on advancing gerontological social work education. The biological domains are normal aging, functional limitations and adaptation, decrease in the weight of the brain, impaired immune system, loss of nerve cells, ischemic lesion. It is called as the condition in which there is a insufficient blood flow to the brain to meet the metabolic demand. Decreased psychomotor activity, loss of sensory capacity, change in appearance, sleep disturbance, accidental problems, and psychological domains. The psychological domains are late life development, grief and loss, deterioration of mental activity, change in emotional behavior, personality changes, and including social domains like family and social support network, social isolation, dependence on others for everything, feeling of insecurity, unemployment and retirement. The life of an individual can be divided into five main stages, namely infancy, childhood, adolescence, adulthood and old age. In each of these stages, an individual has to find himself in different situations and face different problems. The old age is not without problems. In old age, physical strength deteriorates, mental stability diminishes, money power becomes decreased due to inability to work, and other associated problems may weaken the old age, and old one become fragile. Gerontology deals with all the above concerns of older people who are facing age-related problems. Gerontology being a multidisciplinary subject that have different subfields which concern with the study of all aspects of old age. The scope of gerontology is quite comprehensive, containing many disciplines and professionals who focus on various aspects of aging and development. Gerontologists, including researchers and practitioners in the fields of biology, nursing, medicine, criminology, dentistry, social work, physical and occupational therapy, psychology, psychiatry, sociology, economics, political science, architecture, geography, pharmacy, public health, housing, and anthropology.